Hello everyone. In the previous session, I have done a concept of random variable and expectations and a problem based on it. So, third problem. In this session, let me continue the problems on the same concept. So, here I have a third problem. Show that the following distribution represent a discrete probability distribution. Find mean and variance. In the sense, in previous problems, where we have only event given, we have to construct a distribution and then we have to find mean and variance. But in this case, probability distribution is given in the problem itself. We have to verify whether it represents discrete probability distribution or not. So as I already told you in the previous session, when do we say distribution is discrete probability distribution? Only when it satisfies two conditions, right? So first condition is that probability of all the events, that is probability of xi, should be greater than or equal to 0. And the second condition is that sum of all the probabilities of the random variables should be equal to 1, right? So if a probability distribution satisfies these two conditions, we can say it is a discrete probability distribution. So first let me verify. Anyhow, the table is given in the problem itself. So from the given table, let me extract the value. So this value is x1, x2, x3 and x4. So I'll just write the solution here. From the given data or from the given table, I can write x1 is equal to 10, x2 is equal to 20, x3 is equal to 30 and x4 is equal to 40. Right? Now, let me find the, or else, first let me write the probability of the variables as well. So probability of x1 is given 1 by 8, probability of x2 is given, it is 3 by 8, probability of x3 is given, it is also 3 by 8, and probability of x4 is given, it is 1 by 8, whatever the given data I have just listed here. Now you can clearly see that first condition that we need to verify is probability of all the events of a random variable should be greater than or equal to 0. Now you can clearly note that here 1 by 8 and 3 by 8 as well as 3 by 8 and 1 by 8, all the events are greater than or equal to 0, right? If you divide these values, you will definitely get the values greater than or equal to 0. Therefore, I can write probability of all the events is greater than or equal to 0. So first condition is verified. Second condition, we have to verify that sum of all the probability should be equal to 1. Sum in the sense, here how many random variables is there? 1, 2, 3, 4. So you have to put 4 numbers. That is, I value should be given right from 1 to 4. That is, I can write this as probability of x1 plus probability of x2 plus probability of x3 plus probability of x4. Now what is the value of probability of x1? It is 1 by 8. x2 is 3 by 8. Probability of x3 is again 3 by 8. Again, probability of x4 is 1 by 8. Now let me take the LCM. So when you take LCM, you will get 1 plus 3 plus 3 plus 1. So let me add all these values. So you will get 1, 3 plus 3 is 6, 7 plus 1 is 8. 8 by 8 will be 1. So clearly sum of all the variables, probability of all the random variables is equal to 1. Since it satisfies both the condition, therefore I can say the given distribution is a discrete probability distribution. Therefore, this conclusion is mandatory. You have to write distribution is discrete. As I already told you, there are two types of probability distribution. First one is discrete and second one is continuous. So discrete in the sense it should satisfy these two conditions. So discrete probability distribution. Fine, so this is the first question. Next, we have first is we have verified that the given distribution is discrete probability distribution. Next, we have to find mean and variance. So let me find the mean and variance. So as I already given the formula list, how do we calculate mean? Formula is given by mu is equal to I is equal to 1 to n xi into probability of xi. So here how many random variables are there? 4 variables. So I have to give it as 1. That is, 4 terms. So x1 into probability of x1 plus x2 into probability of x2 plus x3 into probability of x3 plus x4 into probability of x4. Anyhow, all the values are given in the table itself. So let me substitute. x1 is 10 into probability of x1 is 1 by 8 plus x2 is 20, probability of x2 is 3 by 8 plus x3 is 30 into probability of x3 is again 3 by 8 plus x4 is 40, probability of x4 is 1 by 8. Now let me simplify all these values. So I'll just simplify here. So you will get mu is equal to 10 divided by 8. Since I have 8 in the denominator, so it is better to keep 8 as it is. It's very useful in taking LCM. So 10 into 1 is 10 by 8 plus 20 into 3 is 60 by 8 plus 33 is 90 divided by 8 plus 40 into 1 is 40 by 8. Now let me take LCM. So you will get 10 plus 60 plus 90 plus 40. So you will get, when you add all this, you will get 200 divided by 8. So this will be the required mean. Mu is equal to 200 by 8. So let me divide. You will get again 25 times. So mu is equal to 25. Next, what we need to calculate is, we have already calculated mean. Next, we have to calculate variance. So let me write down the formula for variance. Variance, V is given by summation I is equal to 1 to n xi minus mu square into probability of xi, right? Anyhow, let me substitute mu here only. So xi minus mu is 25. We have already calculated 25 square into probability of xi. I have just substituted the mu value, that is mean value. Now, since we have four random variables here, 1, 2, 3, 4, so I have to write 4 terms here, right? First, variance is equal to, let me substitute I as 1. For the first time, you will get x1 minus 25 square into probability of x1 plus, next I plus, you just put 2, to x2 minus 25 whole square into p of x2. Plus x3 minus 25 whole square into p of x3 plus x4 minus 25 whole square into p of x4. Since we have only 4 terms here, so you have to stop up to 4. So that is what I have done here. Now let me substitute the values. So what is the value of x1 here? It is 10. So let me substitute x1 as 10 minus 25 square. What is the probability of x1? It is 1 by 8. Plus x2 is 20 minus 25 square. Probability of x2 is 3 by 8. Plus again x3 is 30 minus 25 square. Probability of x3 is 3 by 8. Plus x4 is 40 minus 25 square. Probability of x4 is 1 by 8. Fine. Now let me simplify this. So I'll just do here. Next is 10 minus 25. I'll just do it directly. You just listen to me. 10 minus 25. Or else let me write one more step. 10 minus 25 is minus 15 square into 1 by 8. Plus 20 minus 25 is also minus 5 square into 3 by 8. Plus 30 minus 25. 30 minus 25 is 5. 5 square into 3 by 8. Plus 40 minus 25. 40 minus 25 is plus 15 square into 1 by 8. Fine. Now minus 15 square is 225 divided by 8. Plus minus 5 square is 25. 25 into 3 is 75 divided by 8. Plus 5 square is 25. 25 3 is 75 divided by 8. Plus 15 square is 225 into 1 is 225 divided by 8. Now let me take the LCM. LCM is 8, so you will get 225 plus 75 plus 75 plus 225. So when you add all these terms, you will get 600. So let me simplify further. So you will get 8 ones are 875. So variance is 75. Hope so it is clear. I'll just repeat variance once again. You just write down the formula. As per the given distribution, we have totally 4 variables. Random variables, so you just write 4 terms here and then substitute the required values. Since I have taken LCM 8 here, so in the numerator you will get 225 plus 75 plus 75 plus 225. So when you add all, you will get 600. So after simplification, required variance will be 75 and mean will be 25. So as usual, I have done. So hope so it is clear. Let me solve one more problem. So here is the next problem. It is quite different. A random variable hex has the following probability distribution. So it is given that the distribution is itself a random variable. That is, given distribution is random probability distribution. Fine. So whose xi values are given and probability values are given. But probability values are in terms of unknown variable k. So first question is, we need to find k. First, let me solve first sub question. So solution of first sub question. Now, by the definition of discrete probability, why? Because it is given that for a random variable, it is a discrete probability distribution. So, as it is discrete probability definition, what it says? I'll just write the statement, by the definition of discrete probability distribution, what is the two conditions? First condition is that probability of all the, I'll just make it A, why? Because I've chosen 1 year only. So probability of all the events should be greater than or equal to 0. And second condition is that probability, sum of all the values of probability of a random variable should be equal to 1. Right? Now, you just see the values of probability of xi values, they should be positive. And all the sum will be equal to 1. Right? So, I'll just use second condition in order to find the value of k. Since it is a random distribution, that is, what we say? Discrete probability distribution. So I can write their probability sum is equal to 1. What is the meaning of the statement is I is none other than number of random variables. How many variables we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Right? So let me take this as x1, x2, x3, x4, x5, x6, x7, x8. So their sum should be equal to 1. Therefore, by the second condition, I can write probability of x1 plus probability of x2, probability of x3, plus probability of x4, plus probability of x5, plus probability of x6, plus probability of x7, plus probability of x8 should be equal to 1 from the definition of a random discrete probability distribution. Right, so all the sum of all the probability of an event should be equal to 1. That is second, by the second condition I have written this. Now what is the probability of x1? It is given as 0. Plus what is the probability of x2? K. Probability of x3, it is given, probability of x3 is 2k. Probability of x4 is again 2k. Probability of x5 is 3k. Probability of x6 is k square. x7 2k square plus x8 is 7k square plus k, and the sum should be equal to 1. Clear? Whatever the given data, I have make use the second condition. Now let me simplify this statement. So I can write this as, see here, k plus 2k plus 2k, 2k plus 2k 4k, 4k plus k is 5k, 5k plus 3k is 8k. Fine? 8k, again you have 1k here, I'll just make it 9 here. Fine? See here, 1, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, again 1, 9, 9k. Next k squares are 7 plus 2, 7, 8, 9, 10. So you will have total 10k square. Again, plus 1 I have, so I'll just shift here, minus 1 will equal to 0. I'll just repeat once again, I have added all the k's, it is 9k. Again, I have added all the k squares and I have shifted 1 to left hand side, so you will get 9k plus, I'll just arrange this in a standard format, 10k square plus 9k minus 1 is equal to 0. And you know that this is a quadratic equation, you can find the factor. So 10 into minus 1 is minus 10. Factors for minus 10 is plus 10 and minus 1, so that when you subtract you will get plus 9 only. So I can split this as 10k square plus 10k minus k minus 1 is equal to 0. Let me take 10k as common, so you will get k plus 1. Again minus 1 as common, so you will get k plus 1. So again k plus 1 will be common, you get 10k minus 1, as you already solved the quadratic equation n number of times. So k plus 1 value will be equal to 0, or 10k minus 1 value will be equal to 0. Or else I can write k is equal to minus 1, k is equal to 1 by 10. Since k value cannot be negative, why? Because probability of an event is always positive. From the first condition, it should be positive. But here what we have, probability, I have obtained k value as negative. K is none other than when you are going to substitute k values in the probability in the second column. So you will get values are probability values, right? So probability of an event cannot be negative. They should be positive. Greater than or equal to meaning is they are positive values. So I cannot accept negative value. Therefore, k value is positive. It is 1 by 10. Now let me substitute all those values. So you will get probability. Anyhow, first sub question is finished, right? So they have asked you to find the value of k. So that is what the k value I have done here. Now, to solve the second question, see here, second question, what they have asked is, we have to evaluate probability of an event up to less than 6. Less than 6 meaning is, x6, less than x6 is x1, x2, x3, x4, x5, all are less than x6 only. So, probability of x less than 6 is none other than probability of 0 plus probability of 1 plus probability of 2 plus probability of 3 plus probability of 4 plus probability of 5. You should not include 6 there. Why? Because we don't have equal sign here. So up to 5 you have to add. Now probability of 0. Probability of 0 is none other than 0 only. Fine. Probability of 1. 1 is none other than k. But we don't know the k. In the first case we have obtained the k value. So that is why we need this value again. So let me write the tabular column once again by substituting the values of k. I'll just calculate this. Fine. X size. And probability of xi. So xi value for the first time xi value is 0, right? So when it is 0, probability is also 0. So x2 is 1. So 1 in the sense k value is 1 by 10. Next it is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So it is 2 in the sense 2 into k. 2 into k meaning is, I'll just simplify here so that you'll understand well. 2 into k, 2 into 1 by 10, 2 1s are 2 5s are. So you will get 1 by 5. Next, 3 meaning is 2k. So 2k meaning is 2 into 1 by 10 again. So 2 into 1 by 10 is 1 by 5 only. Next, 4 is 3k. 3 into 1 by 10. So you will get 3 by 10 only. Next, 5 meaning is k square. K is 1 by 10. So, k square in the sense, 1 by 10 square. So, 1 by 10 square is 1 by 100. Next, for 6k, it is 2 into k square. So, 2 into 1 by 100 you will get. So, 2 into 1 by 100 is 1 by 50. So, you just simplify. Or else, if you want, you can write as it is. Fine. Next, 7 meaning is 7k square plus k. 7 into k square means... k square, I'll just write as it is, 7k square plus k. Now k square is none other than 1 by 100 plus k is 1 by 10. So let me simplify, 7 by 100 plus 1 by 10. Clear? Now let me take LCM, 100 plus 100 and 10 LCM is 100 only. So if you take 100 as an LCM, you will get 7 plus 1, you will get... I'm sorry, 7 plus, when you multiply 10, 100 here, 10 ones are 10 tens, so you will get 10 here, 7 plus 10 you will get, so you will get 17 by 100. Fine, 7k square plus k value I have simplified here, you will get 17 by 100, so I will substitute here, 17 by 100. So now you know all the probability value, but we don't know all the values where we have in terms of unknowns k. Fine, so I have substituted k value and I have simplified and I have listed the values here. Now I can make use of all these values. See here, what is the probability of 1 now? 1 by 10, you just write here. Fine, probability of 2 is 1 by 5. Probability of 3 is 1 by 5 again. Fine, next, probability of 4 is, it is 3 by 10. Probability of 5 is 1 by 100. Now let me simplify this. I'll just simplify here. See here, what is the, now I'm simplifying for probability of x less than 6. What is the LCM here? Denominator 1. So LCM for 10, 5 and 100. LCM for 10, 5 and 100 is 100 only. So let me take LCM as an 100. So when you take 100 as an LCM, you will get 0 here. So when you multiply 100, 10 ones are 10 tens. So you will get 10. Hope so LCM is known for all of you. So when you multiply 100 here, you will get 20 times. So 20 plus 20 plus, when you multiply 100 here, you will get 10. 10 into 33 is 30 plus 100 into 1 is 100. Now 20 plus 20 40 plus 10 is 50 plus 30 80. 80 plus 1 is 81. So you will get 81 by 100. Therefore probability of x less than 6 is 81 by 100. So this is the solution for second sub question. Probability of x less than 6 is 81 by 100. Now, next question is probability of x greater than or equal to 6. Greater than or equal to 6 is there. We have to add from 6, x6 value. Remember, x6, x7, x8. Everything will be greater than or equal to 6 only. Right? So, I'll just solve here. Probability of x greater than or equal to 6 can be written as probability of 6 plus probability of 7. And one more key point is that, remember, when you are noting probability of x greater than or equal to 6, you have to look at the table values of 6. In the sense, here xi values, you have to look at these values. You cannot consider x0, x1, x2 values. See here, this value will be reference to x1. So x1, x2, x3, x4, x5, x6, x7, x8. When you count x values, you will get up to x8. But when they asked you to find probability of x greater than or equal to 6, you have to look at the column x here. This will be capital X. Fine. So capital X value greater than or equal to 6, equal to 6 in the sense 6 value you have to consider, again 7 value you have to do. So probability of 6, what is the probability of 6 here? 1 by 50 plus probability of 7 is 17 by 100. Hope so it is clear for you what I am explaining, right? Let me take LCM here. So LCM for 50 and 100 is 100 only. So when you multiply, you will get 2 here, right? See here, 51s are 52s are. So you will get 2 plus 17. So when you simplify, you will get 2 plus 17 is 19. 19 by 100. Therefore, probability of x greater than or equal to 6 is 19 by 100. Clear? Now we have one more question in the same problem. We have done x greater than or equal to 6, but we have to do probability of x between 0 and 5. So x greater than 0, meaning of the statement is x less than 5 and x greater than 0. Clear? X greater than 0 and x less than 5. In the sense, we have to find x value between 0 and 5. So I'll just do it here. Probability of 0 less than x less than 5. So we can write this as, so what are the values between 0 and 5? See here, I'll just write here 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So between x lies between 0 and 5, meaning is numbers between 0 and 5. It is 1, 2, 3, 4, right? So I can write this as probability of 1 plus probability of 2 plus probability of 3 plus probability of 4. What is the value of probability of 1? 1 is here. So probability of 1 is 1 by 10. Plus probability of 2 is 1 by 5. Plus probability of 3 is 1 by 5. Probability of 4 is 3 by 10. Now LCM for 5 and 10 is 10 only. So you will get 1 plus 2 plus 2 plus 3. So 3 plus 1 is 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So you will get, 2 plus 2, 4. 4 plus 1 is 5. 5 plus 3 is 8. 8 by 10. So probability of 0 less than x less than 5 will be equal to 8 by 10. So hence the solution for the last question, probability of 0 less than x less than 5. So first I have obtained the value of k by using these two conditions. Next, probability of x less than 6, in the sense you have to consider less than 6, meaning is leaving 6, you have to consider 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. So that is what I have written here. Fine. Similarly, greater than 6, meaning is greater than or equal to 6 is there here. So equal to, meaning you have to consider 6 as well as 7. So that is what I have done here. Between 0 and 5, meaning is you have to consider the numbers between 0 and 5, but you should not consider 0 and 5. Suppose if you have equal sign here, then you should consider 0 and 5. Since you don't have equal sign here, so we are considering only one in between value, that is 1, 2, 3, 4. So hope so it is clear. So let me solve one more. So here is the next problem, which is quite similar to the previous one. Here also we have a probability distribution function of a random variable x. We have to find the value of k. So as we done in the previous problem, I am following the same procedure. First we have to write by the definition of discrete probability distribution. Discrete probability distribution. So what it is says, it says two conditions, right? That is, probability of all the random variables should be greater than or equal to 0. That quantity should be positive. And sum of all the probability of random variables should be equal to 1. So sum of the random variables should be equal to 1. Second condition I will be using to find the value of k. So how many variables we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 variables. So we have to put I value 7. That is, I can write probability of x1 plus probability. Therefore, probability of x1 plus probability of x2 plus probability of x3 plus probability of x4 plus probability of x5 plus probability of x6 plus probability of x7 will be equal to 1. Now let me substitute. What is the value of probability of x1? K. Similarly, probability of x2, 3k. Probability of x3, 5k. Probability of x4, 7k. Probability of x5,
9k, x6 11k, x7 is 13k, which is equal to 1. Now let me simplify, let me add all these values. So when you add all these coefficients, you will get 49k is equal to 1. So this implies k value will be equal to 1 divided by 49. So first question is finished. Next question, as usual, second sub question. So I'll just make it as A and B. So second sub question, we have to find probability of x less than or equal to 5. So as I already told you, whenever we need x less than or equal to y, first we have to substitute k value. Anyhow, we required it in further calculation. So let me rewrite the distributions. So xi and probability of xi. So what are the xi values? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I'll just substitute. K is none other than 1 by 49. Next. Similarly, let me substitute k. 3 into 1 by 49. It is 3 by 49. Next, 5 into 1 by 49. 5 by 49. Next, 7 by 49. 9 by 49. 11 by 49. 13 by 49. Just I have substituted k as 1 by 49. That's it. Clear? Once you have done with this, now we have to find probability of x less than or equal to 5. Meaning of this statement is, we have to consider the values of x which is less than 5, also equal to 5. So less than 5 in the sense 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Equal to 5 in the sense this 5 value also we have to write. So probability of x less than or equal to 5 meaning is, we have to add probability of 0 plus probability of 1 plus probability of 2 plus probability of 3 plus probability of 4 plus probability of 5. What is the probability of 0 here? We have already calculated in terms of known values, 1 by 49. See, you cannot calculate in terms of k. Why? Because it is unknown. So once you substituted the value of k, then you can use those values. Probability of 1 is 3 by 49. Plus probability of 2 is 5 by 49. One thing is that my suggestion is, don't simplify the terms if it get cancelled. So if you keep as it is, it will be helpful in taking LCM. Why? Because denominator will be same. Probability of 3 is 7 by 49. 4 is 9 by 49. Probability of 5 is 11 by 49. Clear? Now let me take the LCM. So 49 will be LCM. You will get 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9 plus 11 will be 36. Fine. So probability of x less than or equal to 5 will be 36 by 49. Clear? Next, what we need to calculate is probability of 3 less than x less than or equal to 6. I'll be doing here. Third question. Probability of 3 less than x less than or equal to 6. Meaning of this statement is, we have to consider the values of x which is greater than 3. But less than or equal to 6. See here, greater than 3, I'll just see here. X greater than 3 meaning is, greater than 3 is 4, 5, 6. Equal to 6 in the sense, you have to consider 6 as well. So I'll just write this as probability of, you don't have equals here. So you should not consider 3. After 3, you have to consider. Meaning is, X greater than 3. X is greater than 3. Greater than 3, if you have equals here, then you have to consider 3. You don't have equals here, so you have to write it from 4. So probability of 4 plus probability of 5 plus probability of 6. Anyhow, we have calculated it. So probability of 4 is 9 by 49. Probability of 5 is 11 by 49. Plus probability of 6 is 13 by 49. So let me take LCM. 49 will be the LCM. So you will get 9 plus 11 plus 13. So it will give you 33 divided by 49. Therefore, probability of 3 less than x less than or equal to 6 will be 33 by 49. Clear? Now the last question is probability of x greater than or equal to 5. Fine. So probability, fourth question is probability of x greater than or equal to 5. See here, we have greater than or equal to 5. So you have to consider 5 also. Probability of 5. Why? Because you have 5 here. Equals here. Fine. So equal to 5. And greater than 5 is none other than probability of 6 it is. Clear? Now what is the value of probability of 5? We have already done here. It is 11 by 49 plus probability of 6 is 13 by 49. Now let me take the LCM. 49, you will get 11 plus 13. 3 plus 1 is 4, 1 plus 1, 2. So 24 by 49. Therefore, probability of x greater than or equal to 5 is 24 by 49. Here is the next problem. A random experiment of pair of dice are to be tossed. Let x be a random variable defined to be a sum of the points. Find the discrete probability distribution. Also find its mean and variance. So a pair of dice are to be tossed. Here in the question you can clearly see that a pair of dice are thrown. So out of as I already told you, when a pair of die is thrown, you will get only numbers from 1 to 6 when one die is thrown. Suppose when a pair of die, in the sense when two dice are thrown, there are 36 possible outcomes. So I'll just list all the possible outcomes when you throw two dice. Fine. So when you throw two dice, the possible outcomes will be 1,1, 2,1, 3,1, 4,1, 5,1, 6,1, 1,2, 1,3, 1,4, 1,5, 1,6. Similarly, 2,2, 2,3, 2,4, 2,5, 2,6, 3,1, 3,2, 3,3, 3,4, 3,5, 3,6, 4,1, 4,2, 4,3, 4,4, 4,5, 4,6, 5,1, 5,2, 5,3, 5,4, 5,5, 5,6, 6,1, 6,2, 6,3, 6,4, 6,5, 6,6. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6. So total 36. Fine. So these are the possible outcome when you throw a pair of die. Pair in the sense two dice. Fine. So when you throw only one die, you will get 1 to 6 outputs. Fine. Now here x is a random variable which is defined to be sum of the points. Fine. So x is sum of points. So I'll just make a list of all xi's here. So sum of points in the sense 1 plus 1 you have to add, it is 2. Next 2 plus 1, 3. 3 plus 1, 4. 4 plus 1, 5. 5 plus 1, 6. 6 plus 1, 7. Next 1 plus 2, 3. It is already written, so I am going to avoid all the repetition. 2 plus 2, 4. It is done. 3 plus 2, 3 plus 2 is 5. Done. 4 plus 2, 6. 5 plus 2, 7, 6 plus 2, 8. So 8 is not done, so I am going to write it. Next 1 plus 3, 4, 1 plus 4, I'll just try check by column wise. 3 plus 1, 4, 4 plus 1, 5, 5 plus 1, 6, 6 plus 1, 7. So everything is done. 2 plus 1, 3, 2 plus 2, 4, 2 plus 3, 5, 4 plus 2, 6, 5 plus 2, 7, 6 plus 2, 8, I have already done. 3 plus 1, 4, 2, 3 plus 2, 5, 3 plus 3, 6, 3 plus 4, 7, 3 plus 5, 8, 6 plus 3, 9. So I'll just write 9 here. Next 4 plus 1 already done, 4 plus 2, 4 plus 3 done, 4 plus 4, 8 already done, 4 plus 5, 9 already done, 6 plus 4 is 10. So I'm going to write it. 5 plus 1, 6, 5 plus 2, 7, 8, 9, 10 already done. So 6 plus 5 is 11. So I have to write 11. Next 6 plus 1 is 7, 6 plus 2 is 8. Again, I've done all this. 6 plus 4 is 10, 6 plus 5 is 11, 6 plus 6 is 12. So I have added all the possible sums without repetition. Fine. Just a sum of the two terms in a dice. Fine. This is what the xi value. Now let me write the distribution, that is P of xi. Corresponding probability distribution I have to write. Now probably xi is 2. 2 meaning is whenever you are going to get 2, only when you add 1 plus 1 you will get 2. Right? So one more possibility. Do we have any possibility here? No. So how many times you are going to get 1? 1,1? Only 1 times out of 36 times. So you will get 1 by 36 here. Next 3. So 3 will come only when you add 1 plus 2 and 2 plus 1. Fine? You will get only in these 2 chances. Apart from these 2, you will never get 3 when you add 2 numbers. So these 2 chances will get out of 36. So 2 chances out of 36. Next 4. 4 in the sense 3 plus 1 you will get 4. Again 2 plus 2 you will get 4. Again 3 plus 1 4. So how many chances are there? Only 3 chances out of 36. So you will get 3 by 36. Next 1 plus 4 5. 2 plus 3 5. 3 plus 2 5. 4 plus 1 5. So when you add all these 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 chances, then only you will get 5. Apart from this, you will never get 5. So you will get 4 chances out of 36.
clear? Let me write 6 similarly. So you will get 5 by 6, 5 by 36. Why? Because see here, when you add 5 plus 1, 6, 2 plus 4, 6, 3 plus 3, 6, 4 plus 2, 6, 5 plus 1, 6. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 chances out of 36. Similarly, 7, in the sense 6 plus 1, 7, 2 plus 5, 7, 3 plus 4, 7, 4 plus 3, 7, 5 plus 2, 7, 6 plus 1, 7. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 chances out of 36 chances. Similarly, 8, 6 plus 2, 8, 3 plus 5, 8, 4 plus 4, 8, 5 plus 3, 8, 6 plus 2, 8. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 chances out of 36 chances. Clear? Next, similarly, let me write 9. 9 in the sense 6 plus 3, 9, 4 plus 5, 9, 5 plus 4, 9. So 6 plus 3 is also 9. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 chances out of 36 chances. Next, 10, 4 plus 6, 10, 5 plus 5, 10, 6 plus 4, 10. So 3 chances out of 36. Next, 11, 5 plus 6 and 6 plus 5 is 11. So 2 chances out of 36. Next, 12 is only 1 chance out of 36. Clear? Just I have written a probability. Now we have to check whether it is a discrete probability distribution or not. So there are two conditions to set a distribution is discrete probability distribution. First one is that probability of all the xi, that is random value, should be greater than or equal to 0, and second one is that sum of all the probability distribution should be equal to 1. Anyhow, it is all positive quantity, that is greater than or equal to 0 only. Let me check the last condition, that is you just add all these values so that the sum should be equal to 1. Now let me check, that is sum of I p of xi is none other than probability of x1, this is nothing but x1 plus x2. How many events are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So probability of x3 plus probability of x4 plus probability of x5 plus probability of x6 plus probability of x7 plus probability of x8 plus probability of x9 plus probability of x10 plus probability of x11. Fine. Now you substitute all the values. So 1 by 36 plus 2 by 36 plus 3 by 36 plus 4 by 36 plus 5 by 36 plus 6 by 36 plus 5 by 36. Remember, you should not simplify this term. So if you are not simplify, you will get a very easy method to find the LCM. 4 by 36 plus 3 by 36 plus 2 by 36 plus 1 by 36. Now you can note that denominator all same, it is 36. So LCM for 36 is 36 only. So remaining in the numerator, 2 plus 1, 3, 3 plus 3 is 6, 6 plus 4, 10, 10 plus 5, 15, 15 plus 6, 21, 21 plus 5, 26, 26 plus 4, 30, 30 plus 3, 33, 33 plus 2, 35 plus 1, 36. 36, 36 get cancelled. Therefore, you will get sum of all the probability of random variables as 1. Since it satisfies both the condition, therefore I can say the required probability distribution is a discrete distribution. I'll just write one statement. Therefore, the distribution is discrete probability distribution. Fine. So first one is clear. Same as the previous problem procedure, but this thing you have to remember. Next, what we have to find is also find mean and variance. So as I already given formula to calculate mean and variance, so please go through that. Anyhow, I'll just solve here. First thing is I have to find mean. So as I already given, mean is represented by mu. Formula is given by summation I from 1 to 11. Why? Because we have totally 11 events here. 11 random variables. So I is equal to 1 to 11 xi into probability of xi. So 11 times you have to write. So mu is equal to x1 into probability of x1 plus x2 into probability of x2 plus x3 into probability of x3 plus x4 into probability of x4 plus x5 into probability of x5 plus x6 into probability of x6 plus x7 into probability of x7. Oops, so it is visible, right? Yeah. Plus x8 into probability of x8 plus x9 into probability of x9 plus x10 into probability of x10 plus x11 into probability of x11. Now let me substitute all the values. So what is the value of x1? Is 2. 2 into
probability of x1, what is the value of probability of x1? It is 1 by 36. Clear? Plus x2 is 3, 3 into probability is 2 by 36, plus x3 is 4, probability is 3 by 36, plus 5 into 4 by 36, plus 6 into, I am just substituting, 5 by 36, plus 7 into 6 by 36, plus 8 into 5 by 36, plus 9 into 4 by 36, plus 10 into 3 by 36, plus 11 into 2 by 36, plus 12 into 1 by 36. Just a substitution in a formula. Now let me simplify all these terms. So mu is equal to, now what we have here, 2 into 1 by 36, it is 2 by 36, plus 3 2s are 6, 6 by 36, plus 4 3s are 12, 12 by 36, plus 5 4s are 20, 20 by 36, plus 30 by 36, plus 7 into 6 is 42, 42 by 36, plus 40 by 36, plus 40, 36 by 36, 9 4s are 36, right? So 10 into 3 is 30 by 36, plus 11 2s are 22 by 36, plus 12 1s are 12 by 36. Now let me take the LCM. So you will get mu is equal to 36. So when you take 36 is a common term, so when you take LCM you will get all the sum of numerator. So 2 plus 6 plus 12 plus 20 plus 30 plus 42 plus 40 plus 36 plus 30 plus 32 plus 12. So if you add all these values you will get 252. So let me simplify, it is 7. Fine. Therefore you will get mu, that is mean value, is 7. Fine. So this is the required mean value. But what else we need to calculate is, we need to calculate variance as well. Fine. So this is what the mean of a given data. Hope so it is clear. You just copy down to the notes. So let me solve variance of the distribution. So as you already familiar, formula for variance is given by variance. V is equal to summation I is equal to 1 to 11. Why? Because we have 11 terms there. Xi minus mu square into probability of xi. I have given a formula list, please go through the formula list. There you have a formula for variance. Clear? Probability of xi. Now I have to give I values right from 1 to 11. Before that let me substitute the mean value. I is equal to 1 to 11, xi minus mu value is 7, 7 square into probability of xi. Now let me substitute the values of I right from 1 to 11, so that you will get, for the first time you substitute I is equal to 1 in this. So you will get x1 minus 7 square into probability of x1, plus x2 minus 7 square into probability of x2, plus x3 minus 7 square into probability of x3, plus x4 minus 7 square into probability of x4, plus x5 minus 7 square into probability of x5, plus x6 minus 7 square into probability of x6, plus x7 minus 7 square into probability of x7, plus x8 minus 7 square into probability of x8, plus x9 minus 7 square into probability of x9, plus x10 minus 7 square into probability of x10, plus x11 minus 7 square into probability of x11. Why? Because we have totally 11 terms. Fine. See here. I'll just show you. See here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So that is why I have given right from 1 to 11 for calculation of variance. Now let me substitute all the values. So look at the values I have written here. So. Fine. So let me do here. X1 value is probability is 1 by 3. See, x1 value is 2 minus 7 square. Probability is 1 by 36. Plus x2 is 3 minus 7 square into probability is 2 by 36. Clear? Just refer the table and substitute the values. Fine. Plus x3 is x1 here. If you want, you can write here only x3, x4, x5, x6, x7, x8, x9, x10, x11. So now you can see, right? x3 is 4. 4 minus 7 square into probability of x4 is 4 by 36. See here, x3 you are writing. So x3 is 3 by 36. I will show you. See here, 3 by 36 here. Here you can see, right? Now, plus x4. What is the value of x4? It is 5. 5 minus 7 square into, what is the value of probability of x4? 4 by 36. Fine. Next, plus x5. What is the value of x5? See here, x5 is 6. Minus 7 square into probability of x5 is 5 by 36. Plus x7 is 7. Minus 7 square into probability is 6 by 36. Plus 8 minus 7 square into probability is 5 by 36. Next, 9 minus 7 square into 4 by 36. Plus 10 minus 7 square into probability is 3 by 36. You can note here. See, x10 is 11 minus 7 square into probability is 2 by 36. Next, 12 minus 7 square into probability is 1 by 36. Just I have made a substitution. Now, here is a simplification. See, all the problems are almost lengthy. But the thing is, you need to practice more. More the problems you practice, more accurate you will get. So that there will be less time consumption if you practice well. If not, it takes more time even though the problem is simple. So please do practice well. So let me simplify. 2 minus 7, 2 minus 7 is minus 5. I'll just simplify directly. So 2 minus 7 is minus 5. Minus 5 whole square is 25. Clear? So 25 by 36 you will get here. Plus 3 minus 7 is minus, you will get anyhow. So again, it is same as 7 minus 3. It is 4. 4 square is 36. 36 into 2 is, 7 minus 3. 7 minus 3 is 4. 4 square is 16. 16 2s are 32. 32 by 36. Plus 4 minus 7 again. See here, I'll just repeat once again. 7 minus 2 is 5. 5 square is 25. 25 into 1 is 25 by 36. Again, 7 minus 3. 7 minus 3 is 4. 4 square is 16. 16 into 2 is 32. Next, 4 minus 7 here. 4 minus 7 is none other than 7 minus 4. Fine. So 7 minus 4 is 3. 3 square is 9. 9 3s are 27. 27 by 36. Plus 5 minus 7 is 2. 2 square is 4. 4 4s are 16. 16 by 36. Plus, next, 6 minus 7 is 1, 1 square, I mean minus 1, minus 1 square is 1, 1 into 5 is 5, so 5 by 36, plus 7 minus 7 is 0, 0 into anything will be 0, plus 8 minus 7 is 1, 1 square is 1, 1 into 5 is 5, so 5 by 36, plus 9 minus 7, 9 minus 7 is 2, 2 square is 4, 4 4s are 16, so you will get 16 by 36. Please don't simplify here only. Why? Because if you take LCM, terms may get complicated, so keep as it is. Fine. So this term is finished. Next, 10 minus 7, 10 minus 7 is 3, 3 square is 9, 9 3s are 27, 27 by 36, plus 11 minus 7, 11 minus 7 is 4, 4 square is 16, 16 3s are 32 divided by 36, plus again 12, right? So 12 minus 7, 12 minus 7 is 5, 5 square is 25, 25 into 1 is 25 divided by 36. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 terms. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 terms. Now let me take the LCM in order to simplify. So when you take LCM, LCM will be 36. So in the numerator you will get sum of 25 plus 32 plus 27 plus 16 plus 5 plus 5 plus 16 plus 27 plus 32 plus 25. So let me add all these terms. You'll get 210. So it is 210 by 36. Therefore the required variance is 210 by 36. Hope so it is clear. So this is the required mean and this is the required variance. Please copy to the notes. Hope so it is visible now. Take a screenshot of this. page, and please do copy to the notes. So this is the required variance and this is the required mean of a given distribution. Fine. So this completes the problems based on what we say, discrete probability distribution. So the next step is continuous probability distribution. That will be continued in the next session. Thank you.